Hello and welcome to the next video lecture of Marketing Research, Semester 5, Module Number 1. In today's video lecture, we are going to study experimental research and statistical methods. So let us begin. So what is experimental research? Experimental research is a study that strictly adheres to a scientific research design. It includes a hypothesis, a variable that can be manipulated by the researcher, and variables that can be measured, calculated, and compared. Most importantly, experimental research is completed in a controlled environment. The researcher collects data and results will either support or reject a hypothesis which has been set by the researcher. This method of research is referred to as hypothesis testing or a deductive research method. So to simply put it, experimental research can be defined as observation collected under controlled conditions. Generally, in experimental research, as I have told you, there are two groups. The first group is the control group and the other one is the experimental group. So what are these control groups and experimental groups? The subjects in a control group and experimental groups are basically similar in number, characteristics, and features. But the subject in the control group receives no experimental treatment or any interventions at all. Now, just see, we have similar kind of a population or similar type of a sample that we have taken, and we have grouped them into two groups. The first group, we are going to call it as the control group, and the second group we are calling it as experimental groups. And what happens is, in the control group we do no changes. The control group receives no experimental treatment or any intervention or modifications or changes at all. Whereas in experimental group, that is where we have to carry out our experiment, our modifications, our changes, our intervention. Hence, the experimental group receives the planned treatment or intervention, and then because of those planned treatment or interventions, the outcomes of control group and the outcome of the experimental group will be different. Now, this difference can be attributed to the intervention that we have done. That is the planned treatment that we have done. Hence, we can do an experimental research in this way by having intervention only in the experimental group. The experimental group here is the only group that is receiving intervention or any treatment or modifications. And if we observe the effect of this treatment or intervention and find out what is the difference between the outcome of the experimental group and the controlled group, then this difference can be attributed or can be given. Means this outcome that is there, that is the difference in the outcome of the control group, which has received no treatment, no modifications, and the experimental group, which has received some treatment. Now, this difference, whatever is there in the outcome, is only because of the treatment that we are giving. For instance, suppose if we have 1 acre of a field and everything is same, the climatic conditions are same, it is a continuous land, the soil is the same, everything is same, we are watering it also in a very similar way, de-weeding it similarly, only difference the seeds that we are sowing is also the same. The only difference that we are doing in this case is, suppose if we are using two different types of fertilizer, in half of the acre we are using a type of we are not using fertilizer in half of the acre, and in half of the remaining half of the acre we are using a type of fertilizer. Now the yield will come after some months. Everything is same. The only difference between them, that is the intervention, that change we have done in the experimental group, half acre, that is that we have added fertilizer, whereas here we have not done any changes in the control group. So suppose if this half acre gives you certain yield and this half acre gives you certain yield, the difference between yield is because we have used the fertilizer. So this kind of experiment is known as experimental research. Here we have two groups. One is the control group that does not receive any treatment, whereas one is the experimental group that receives the treatment. And the difference in the outcome is only because of that treatment that we have given to the experimental group. Now, this type of research can be used whenever there is quantitative data available. And this is widely used in laboratory experiments or some other social experiments also. The next type of thing that we are going to discuss is statistical research methods. Now, in statistics and quantitative techniques, we have seen numerous types of statistical research methods. Now, after observing the data, recording the data, tabulating the data, it is very important that we use an appropriate statistical research method. Now, data can be of different types. It can be, and the measurement that we are using or the technique that we are applying, that can also be different. We know that it can be a descriptive statistics. We have two types of statistics. One is the descriptive statistics and the other one is the inferential statistics. Now, what is the difference between descriptive statistics and inferential statistics? The basic difference between descriptive statistics and inferential statistics is that descriptive statistics tend to only describe the data, what has happened, whereas inferential data tries to infer something about the population. You do an experiment on a small sample, and the sample from which the population from which the sample has been taken, you infer something about the population based upon the result of the sample. This is inferential statistics. And based upon that, we have seen many methods previously in your previous semesters. We can find out central tendencies, which include mean, median, and mode. We can also find out measures of dispersion, which includes the range, coefficient of range, standard deviation, variance, etc. Then we can also find out correlation, regression between two variables, multiple correlation, multiple regression, that also we can find out. Then these are some of the descriptive methods that we can use in statistical methods. The other part is the inferential statistical method. Inference, as I've said, we try to infer something about the population based upon the sample data. Now, inferential methods basically includes hypothesis testing, and in that we have seen already Z-test, T-test, chi-square test, and some other tests which we have not seen include ANOVA, MONOVA, then some other techniques which are there in inferential statistics. So basically, there are a lot of methods that you can use in statistics, and you can use it for your statistical analysis of your research. Now, very important thing you should understand, whenever you are going to use statistical methods, the data should be quantitative in nature. So quantitative research, under quantitative research, you can do statistical research or statistical methods you can apply. The other thing that is very important is you have to observe the data, collect the data, tabulate it. Then there is a certain procedure called coding, editing, validating. All these things have to happen. After that is filtration of the data, in short, what I can say. More details are there in the later part of your modules. So once you filter and you get convert this raw data into something which we can use for statistical methods, then you have to apply these methods, and appropriate method has to be applied based upon the situation and based upon what you are interested as a researcher to find out. So I hope you have understood today's lecture. If you have any query, you can always contact me.